Huawei's just announced the brand new Mate XS, and I've gone hands-on. So I was lucky enough to be invited to a Huawei pre-brief event in London the week before Huawei announced the Mate XS, and we got to take a look at it along with the new laptops and the new speaker. And yeah, you know, I've got mixed feelings. First impressions, not a lot has changed about the Mate XS when compared to the Mate X from last year. And you can see that in terms of design and in terms of the spec and everything else, but gonna get into that. So let's start with the overall design. Obviously it's very different to what's on offer from the Galaxy Fold and obviously the Z Flip and the Razr, which the latter two are kind of clamshell devices, whereas Huawei is kind of an outside-in book design, whereas the Fold kind of hides the display when you close it, Huawei's is bent around the outside of the display, which comes with its own challenges, because if you do end up dropping the Mate XS and it lands on that spine where there's a display that goes down the side, there could be a few issues there, but obviously I haven't done any durability tests to be able to prove that, but it's my theory. But while they kind of look similar, there have been a bunch of changes to kind of improve the durability of the device, and obviously with foldables, that is the key thing at the moment. Obviously, it's not glass, so it doesn't have that nice finish that glass has. You kind of see a few little bumps and marks here and there from the display, and although you can't actually see the crease, which is a great thing compared to all the other foldables, you can't notice the crease immediately when you look at the Mate XS. But if you do run your finger across the crease, you can feel there's a little something there. But you know, I don't think it's as noticeable as other foldable phones, and the fact that it's kind of horizontal means that, you know, you're not going to swipe on it directly. It's in the middle of the display, so you're not going to swipe straight down the display to kind of see it like that. Whereas on flip phones like the Motorola Razr and the Z Flip, the crease is kind of split right down the middle of the screen. So as you're swiping through Instagram and stuff like that, your finger's going to go over that bump over and over again. And yeah, that's not really something I found with the Mate XS, which is always a plus. Along with a tweaked display, there's obviously an improved hinge. Now that's one of the biggest things with any foldable, because as we've seen with the Fold and everything else, hinges are usually the first thing that give up. Huawei's calling it the Falcon Wing, not quite sure why it's gone with that branding, but they have claimed that there's over 100 components in this hinge that kind of make it durable, and it should last. Keyword there being should, because we can't test it at the moment. What's cool about the new hinge, compared to the original Mate X, is that it kind of clips into place when it's folded back, whereas with the first gen Mate X, you can kind of just fold it back and hold it in place. The new Mate XS has a little clip on the back, so when you snap it in, it holds into place, and there's a little button on the rear that you push to kind of release it, and then you can kind of bend it back around to its tablet form factor. My main issue with the new hinge mechanism is that it's a little bit too tough. There's a lot of resistance there, and obviously you need some resistance so that you don't bend it too far and just snap the display in half. But there's this, you get this resistance, and there's also this kind of crackling noise that I heard during my hands-on with the Mate XS, and I genuinely thought I broke it when I was trying to open it, but you know, the Huawei reps have reassured me that that is just how it is, and it's supposed to kind of reassure you that it's firm and it's durable, but I think there's just a little bit too much resistance, and I feel like I was going to break it. So you know, it's great that the durability is there, and they're working on making something that lasts a lot longer, especially, you know, with such a premium phone. But at the same time, you want it to be smooth, you want it to be seamless, and that's not really what I've found so far. So let's talk about those displays, because that is obviously the most important aspect of any foldable phone. So when it's folded up, on the front you've got a 6.6 inch display, and then on the back you've got a 3.8 inch display. It's slightly smaller because you've got all the cameras on the rear as well. And then once you expand it out, you've got a full 8-inch tablet. And you know, I love the various form factors available. My one kind of issue is the aspect ratio of the 8-inch tablet, because it's essentially square. And you know, 4x3 is kind of the standard for, well, not so much the standard, but it's been around with tablets for a long time. And you know, there's a reason why you want the widescreen. It's better for when you're viewing videos, it's better when you're playing games. And that's kind of one thing I did notice with the Mate XS. Admittedly, I didn't get to play the games on the Mate XS, but Huawei did provide screenshots of PUBG Mobile running on the Mate XS, and seeing it on a square display compared to a widescreen display, you're not seeing as much on, you know, you're not seeing what's going on. So in competitive games like that, you might actually be at a bit of a disadvantage compared to a standard 16x9 smartphone. Obviously with a square 8-inch tablet view, you need apps that can run and take advantage of that big display. And obviously on Android, not all apps work. You know, they don't take advantage of the full screen, they'll kind of force you to go vertical, and that's a big problem. Huawei's answered that with the app multiplier. So basically what it lets you do is it runs the app vertically in two windows. So you've got two windows, one app. The issue is that developers have to specifically add support for this. There's about 1,000 at the moment, Huawei have said, but obviously compared to the overall offerings that you can get, it's kind of a drop in the ocean. I mean, that extends. You've also got kind of multitasking support, so you can run two apps side by side like you can on an iPad. And then you've also got the option to drag and drop a third app onto that display and have it as a floating window that kind of goes between the two. That's a really cool feature, but unfortunately, it's locked to Huawei's own apps at the moment. So you, like the calendar app, the clock app, and files and stuff like that. There's no third-party apps that can actually float on top at the moment. Obviously, the key thing about a folding phone is that it folds and it's smaller than it was. And obviously, with an 8-inch going into a 6.6-inch, you know the form factor is a lot smaller, but it's still thick. When it's folded up, the Mate XS is 11 millimeters thick, which is, you know, it doesn't sound like a lot, but when you've got that in your hand, when you've got that in your pocket, you do notice it compared to, you know, the standard flagship smartphones available in 2020. It's kind of alleviated a little bit once it's opened out, because once you unfold the phone, it goes down to 5.4 millimeters at its thinnest part, which is a lot nicer. But again, you're never going to carry it around fully extended, so you've really got to take into consideration the thickness of when it's folded up. In terms of cameras, there's no front-facing camera. You might have noticed that, but that's not to say you can't take a selfie. While there's no kind of selfie camera on the 6.6-inch segment of the display, on the rear of the phone, you'll have the quad camera setup. With the smaller 6.38-inch display. And that is where you can take your selfies for Snapchat and Instagram, and you can do video calling and all that fun stuff. And obviously, if you want to take a picture of a subject in front of you, you can either go back to the main 6.6-inch with the cameras facing away, or you can open it up into tablet form and have a great big preview of what you're taking pictures of. In terms of specifics, they've got a 40-megapixel main sensor, an 8-megapixel telephoto, 16-megapixel ultrawide, and a 3D depth sensor to help those portrait mode images. There's also a 45x zoom on offer, but this isn't 45x optical. It's 3x optical, 30x digital. You know, it's going to be a bump up from what's available on the Mate 30 Pro. And, you know, that's pretty cool for taking moonshots. But apart from those niche uses, you won't ever use it. And there's also a macro mode where you can take images up to 2.5 centimeters away from the subject. And of course, from the video aspect, you've got both optical image stabilization and artificial intelligence stabilization. So video should be quite smooth and look quite nice, but again, that's something that's really hard to test in a hands-on environment. There's a nice use for the secondary display of the camera unit. So if you're taking a picture of a subject in front of you, like you usually are, you can actually tap a button on the UI to turn on the rear display while keeping the main display active. And now this gives your subject a way to preview the image, and they can kind of tweak their pose a little bit depending on what's going on. And you know, it's not revolutionary by any means, but it's certainly a very handy aspect, and it's something I hadn't really considered from the foldables before. So the key headline in terms of internals is that it comes with Kirin's 990 5G chipset. So the Kirin 990 is 23% quicker than the Kirin 980 from last year, so that should give it a boost in the speed department. And there's also 5G support, again, like last year's model, but this is, according to Huawei, present and future-proof, whatever that means. And then you've also got a 4,500 milliamp hour battery that's split into two segments across the two halves of the phone. And you've got 55 watt fast charging, so that should charge it pretty, pretty quick. And crucially, that charger is in the box. You don't have to buy it separately. And of course, it's worth pointing out that like most Huawei phones at the moment, there's no access to Google Play services on the Mate XS. So you'll be able to get it, but you'll be limited to Huawei's app gallery. And while it does have, you know, a decent selection of apps, it is nowhere near what's available on Google Play. Those that have followed the Mate X's journey from last year will probably be saying, this all sounds pretty familiar, and essentially, you're right. When you kind of look at the design, when you look at the features on offer, there's not a lot that's happened. You know, there's no real change between the Mate X and the Mate XS apart from kind of improvements to the display durability, and that new hinge mechanism, and the bumped up 990 processor. You've kind of got the same camera layout, you've got the same displays, you've got the same resolution. All that stuff is basically the same. So it all revolves around price. Obviously, with it being a spec bump in terms of smartphones, you'd expect the price to come down a little bit, especially as the Mate X from last year was, you know, by far the most expensive foldable on the market. And now when you look at the prices of foldables in 2020, you've got the Z Flip that's kind of around the £1,300 mark. You've got the Motorola Razr that's around the £1,500 to £1,600 mark. You really need the Mate XS to come down in price. But unfortunately, that's not really the case. The Huawei Mate XS is still crazy expensive, and it's out of most people's price range. And crucially, for a phone that costs so much money, you still don't get access to Google Play services, which is a deal breaker for most people. And it's a bit of a shame. So for more on the latest smartphones, gadgets, tablets, and just about anything else, make sure you subscribe and smash that like button.